We would like to begin from Parliament, where the National Assembly's Departmental Committee on Defence and Foreign Relations rejected President William Ruto's nominee for Consul General in the Democratic Republic of Congo, Charles Githinji Keiru. In a report tabled in Parliament, the committee said they had rejected Githinji due to lack of requisite qualities, knowledge, abilities, and experience. Three other nominees of the total 25 approved by the committee possessed average diplomatic knowledge. Here's Ayub Abdikadir.
Githinji Keiru.
Having raised the red flag when he appeared before the Departmental Committee on Defense, Intelligence and Foreign Relations, Charles Githinji Keiru, the nominee for Consul General to the Democratic Republic of Congo, was rejected by the Nelson Koech-led committee. Limitations on scope of knowledge on regional affairs were glaringly on display during his vetting.
For the understanding of the GDP is the growth for the current population and the escalation of the population of that country.
Keiru was hard-pressed to explain inconsistencies in his academic credentials, which were pointed out during the vetting. The members expressing concern about his academic qualifications and his only experience, which was being a former petrol station retailer, director at Ruaraka Choma Inn, and a former cell attendant.
How on earth would you be able to carry out this diplomatic responsibility, given your own limitation in terms of education and experience?
I believe once approved by this committee, I'll be able to go back to school, basically learn the foreign affairs. These are foreign affairs academy, where I'll be able to go through and learn more.
Despite recommending the appointment of the remaining 25 nominees, inexperience, integrity questions, and lacking diplomatic credentials, which dogged some of the nominees, and who will serve Nairobi in critical capitals, were ostensibly not pointed out in the report. The 89-page report also approved nominees to Muscat in Oman, Lusaka, Zambia, and Abu Dhabi in the United Arab Emirates, albeit concerns over their overall knowledge.
I, David Kiplagat Kerich.
And despite questions over their integrity, previous service record, and diplomatic maneuver in an ever-evolving space, nominees for Washington, D.C. and Los Angeles in the United States of America, two critical diplomatic stations, were also approved by the committee.
It's important to consider justice and fairness, so that integrity is not integrity if there's no justice.
But looking at your CV and your experience, you are completely underwhelming as far as your experience of diplomacy is concerned.
My education as a lawyer, one of the subjects that I did in the university was public international law. So I am not that green in diplomacy.
Hi, Peter Mutuku Mathuki.
If approved by the House, the 25 will take up assignments that will see them champion for Kenya's interests in a rather fast-changing diplomatic ecosystem and a world gripped by trade wars and in fear of instability with a war in Europe and volatile Middle East. Ayub Abdikadir, Citizen TV.